that's the chair, that's the sleeper. That's the chair that's on the rail, and they put the wood in, and the wee man walks the track to hammer that in.
Uh-huh. That's very good, that too.
Nowadays, it's a funny steel thing, but I don't know what they've got on those ones. Ah, they're the steel ones, right, too.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Downpatrick and County Down Railway. Now today our trip will take us roughly about 2.5 miles. We're going out here in the direction of Belfast, but don't get excited now, we're not going to Belfast. We're only going to a place called Inch Abbey, which is a 12th century Cistercian Abbey. And by the way, there's a monk out there today, and he'd be able to take you and show you around the abbey if you wish to go. You'll get another train back. If you want to stay in this one comes back in about 10 minutes time. The other one, if you want to stay, will be back roughly in about 40 minutes time. Now, a little about ourselves here, just as you start off. For instance, this particular building here where you got your ticket today is not the original station of Downpatrick. That, in fact, was the town gas manager's home of Downpatrick. And it used to be across the road at that petrol station. The council acquired it and they built it there as our station. Now, the other things that you see sitting around, I'm sure you say to yourself, my goodness, what on earth are you going to do with that there? Well, that's the very last one that's left of the cabin and leap room. That is a rail car. And it's the very, very last one that's left. And if you come back in about 5 years' time, you see for quite a transformation of it. The signal box came from Ballyclare. This building here, which is known as the Macarage Shed, came from Derry, or as Jerry Anderson likes to say in the morning, Derry stroke Londonderry. And it houses, of course, the steam train and, of course, this carriage. Now, as we make our way on out here, you will find that we're turning off to the right. And this line is known as the North Road. You'll also see a line here on your left coming up just a few seconds now. There it is there, coming up. That was the line that was taking you from Downpatrick right through to our class. There was, of course, the occasional train that went to Newcastle as well. Now, the very, very first train ever to come down this line here was on the 23rd of March, 1859. They then set about, of course, extending the railway, reaching Newcastle in 1869 and reaching Ardglass in 1888. Now, the very first thing, of course, they'd done when they got to Newcastle was to build their flagship hotel, and I think they all know it quite well. It's the Slieve Dogger. That, ladies and gentlemen, was built at a cost of £94,000. You couldn't build a kitchen house for it now. Now, as we make our way on out here, you'll notice the main line that came from Belfast right through, of course, to Newcastle. There it is there. And we have line, of course, lead for about a mile and a half out there. Now, of course, you could have been on a train coming from Belfast and you wanted to go to Ardglass, but it was a Newcastle train that you were on. You would have had to change out there at a place called the Loop Platform. And the guard would have walked up and down that platform and you would have heard him in Belfast shouting, "All change, Polly, no, break, clock, Ardglass!" And you would have had to get off there and get onto another train. Now, my first recollections, of course, of trains was a long time ago. I'm looking right here, there's a man here which well remember. 1940. I was a little boy of 8 years old then. So that'll let me know what age you are now. No chicken. I can remember well standing at Queen's Quay Station in Belfast, a wee short pants on me, a wee Burberry, a gas mask over my side, my school bag that clicked in at the front, the leather school bag in your back, you remember it, and of course, your cap on it. I was being evacuated. It was the outbreak of the Second World War. My mother standing, of course, on the platform, in fact, crying her eyes out. To me, I could have been going to the seaside. I had the two worlds. But I got off at Cross Gar, and I was met there by the headmaster of Killalay Primary School. Now, there was another name mentioned that particular day, and that particular man became very, very famous, in fact. And he was on the same train as me. And the name that was mentioned was Gerald Fitt, who later became Lord Fitt of Bells Hill. I was taken to a house opposite Delmon Country Park, and I'm sure a lot of you know where that is, all right. And I spent 4 years away from home. Now, I got don't get me wrong, I was well looked after, and I got my parents visited me every fortnight. But the man that owned Delmon Country Park at that time was Lieutenant Colonel Gordon, and he was an MP in Stormont, and he was a speaker there. And he used to stop and take me to school. Now, I didn't like it very much, but arriving at school in 1940 in a big car wasn't a done thing at all. Anyway, I found out many years later, because that particular house, when it was being demolished to make way for a bungalow, we found a huge stone plaque. And on that plaque, which is now incorporated into the new bungalow, it reads, erected by David Gordon, Esquire of Delmon, 1820, built as a school. So it was actually, his great-grandfather had actually, he knew that, of course. And I presume that's the reason they didn't. Anyway, war years finished, ladies and gentlemen. The very, very last train ever to come down this line here. And if we're just coming up to the point, there is the main line to your left-hand side. That track that runs right down there is the main line that went right through to Belfast. It was on the 15th of January, 1950, 7 o'clock leaving Newcastle, or to be very precise, 2 minutes past 7. She thundered down through there with 7 carriages, right through Saintfield, Ballygan, Crossgar, Saintfield, Ballygan, Cumber, Dundon, Knock Road, Neil's Hill Hut, which is the Sandown Road, Bluefield Station, which is the Beachbridge Road, right across the Hollywood Arches, that's where the Upper Newton Arch Road and Hollywood Road branch, 2 arches there, round the back of Ballymacarra, and into Queen's Quay Station, exactly where the Odyssey is built today. And that was the end of that old section. That was the Hourglass line, the Ballina Inch line, and of course the Newcastle line, completely finished. The other section, of course, which was the Donegal D line, it closed on the 23rd of April of exactly the same year. And the only bit that ever survived, and still survives to this day, is the Belfast Bangor line, which is Northern Ireland Railways. Now this section here, I helped to build this section, and I am not a railway man, as many people think. I was in the shoe business all my life. My wife used to get off, she used to have a heart attack out there, and lift all them big sleepers, because the heaviest thing ever I lifted in my life was a woman's leg to put a shoe on. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we're right here in Inch Abbey. You get a lovely cup of tea here, a coffee for 60p. You'll not get that in Northern Ireland Railways. Or if you want to go up to the Abbey, as I told you before, there's a monk on there and he'll show you.
May as well just start here.
Well, make sure you keep the camera on the mark.
The area we're standing in was known as the nave of the church. Now, the nave of the church was an area where the lay brethren of the